Alright guys, today's lesson is going to be on movement options. I'm going to show you exactly what movement options you can use in order to approach or get away from your opponent, and why doing certain things isn't just the greatest thing to do all the time. I have my friend Spicy here with me, who has joined the room, and he's going to act as the test dummy. Let me take off the timer real quick. I'll get back to the list after I do this. All right, here we go. I'll go Sonic for the hell of it. Who cares? All right, so hold on. Alright, here we go. So guys, movement options. You have a plethora of movement options in Smash, such as your roll, you have short hopping, dashing in, walking. But what's the difference between all of them, right? So check this out. When you're running at your opponent, you're going at maximum speed, which makes you think, okay, I can get to my opponent as fast as I can. Now, what options do you have out of a run? Well, you have your dash attack, you have run and up smash, but try to down smash and you can't do that. Try to F smash and you dash attack. So you have those two options in terms of, let's say, attacking. Now you can always run in and jump, but that just leaves you to do your aerials, not your down smash, your F smash, or a grab. So you can always run in and grab as well. So that's three options. Now, do you see where I'm going with when I talk about running in? That's why in Brawl was actually, people thought of walking to be the better option in Brawl at times, because when you walk in Brawl, you can F smash, you can up smash, you can down smash, you can grab. You have all of those options to your arsenal, your main kill options. Then of course you can still jump into your aerials out of a walk. Now, here's another movement option that you have across the stage. You can roll. Now, the thing about rolling is, watch what happens when I try to do anything out of a roll. I tried to up smash, and you see how I can only up smash at the end of the roll? Let's try that again. Roll and down smash. I can't do anything. I rolled. Roll and up smash. I can't do anything. Roll and F smash. I can't do anything. Roll and jump. I can't do anything. Roll and grab. I cannot do anything. When you roll, you are committed to doing the roll only. That's all you can do. And during the roll animation, you have that brief invincibility, but let's say I'm standing in front of Spicer and he rolls behind me. I can easily punish him off of a grab. It's simple. Roll behind me again. You can F smash the opponent, because at the end of the roll, there's a brief interval where the opponent cannot do anything and they lose their invincibility. Now, that is why when people spam roll, it's bad, because they're not able to use the amount of options that they can out of their other movement options, and they're only using roll because they want that brief feeling of safety from the invincibility that it gives. However, you aren't safe, because a good opponent is going to punish you for rolling over and over and over. So, let's see if your opponent, like little Kevin, runs in and rolls back every single time. Spicer, I would like you to dash attack. I ran in, rolled back, and he dash attacked me to catch me at the end of my roll back. That's the thing. Alright, you don't have to do anything now. When you roll, you're committed to just doing this only, and your opponent is going to punish you for it over and over and over, of course. And little Kevin's case, as I was saying, I was standing in spot to watch him do it over and over and over. However, he thought I was just camping him. Now, this is why rolling is not the best option to move across the stage. It's not the best option to also roll against your opponent, because they can literally just turn around and punish you, and you can get killed for rolling over and over and over. That is why your best movement options are to not roll. You only roll when you need to avoid a move. That's it. You don't roll to try to psych your opponent up with movement, because rolling in general is not actually movement. It's used for safety. It's used to not take damage, but when you're doing it to mind game, quote unquote, your opponent, you're only hurting yourself, and you're gonna get punished for it. Now, that's it in terms of movement options, guys. So, That is why rolling is not something that you want to pick up as a habit. You want to use it as an option, not let it turn into a habit. Because once it turns into a habit, you're going to take a lot of damage, lose a lot of matches, and it's going to hurt you growing, you know, it's going to hurt your growth as a player. Now, I was going to say one more thing, but I forgot. Either way, guys, for glory is not the best approach to practice. Why? 98% of for glory players use roll to move across the stage for everything. They roll because, you know, if you're new to Smash, you want to be safe. And traditionally, newer players are inclined to roll a lot. I was one of those players when I was new as well. I thought rolling is the best, man. I can get across the stage, I can be safe. And then I started to get bopped because I was getting punished for doing it. So, it's not... For glory is not the best method of practice because most players do it because these guys aren't from the competitive Smash community. They don't follow tournaments. They just happen to have a Wii U and they want to play for glory. So, proof's in the pudding, guys. If you don't want to pick up bad habits, play people from the Smash community. Don't depend on For Glory as a form of practice. Because unless you're testing things in there just to be a, like, foolish or whatever, it's not legit. But that's all, guys, for movement options.